So now you can cross verify whether it has a saddle point or not. So this is a method for M cross 2 matrix, that is M cross 2 games. If it has no saddle point, means we have to use the graphical method. If we get the negative value, means it is gained to player B and lost to player A. Everyone, I'm Shweta, Computer Science faculty, Vidyashram First Grade College, Mysuru. In my previous session, I have discussed the problems on 2 cross n games. So today, I will explain the problems on m cross 2 method in graphical method. So first problem, so here we are solving m cross 2 matrix. Solve the following game with payoff matrix of A given in the table. So here, we have M cross 2 games. How it is M cross 2 games? How to find out it is M cross 2 and 2 cross N? For 2 cross N games, you will get 2 rows and N number of columns. And for M cross 2 games, you will get M number of rows and 2 number of columns. That's it. It is very simple concept. 2 cross n games, m cross 2 games. In graphical method, you have 2 methods, that is 2 cross n games and m cross 2 games. If it is 2 cross n game, already have discussed how to solve the 2 cross n method. So now I'm explaining about m cross 2 matrix. So how to solve this m cross 2 matrix in graphical method. So here you have 4 number of rows and 2 number of columns, B1 and B2 and A1, A2, A3, A4 are the rows. So this is called as M cross 2 matrix games. Here the first step is row min. Find the minimum value in row and the maximum value in column. So row min is the minimum value in first row is -2. And the minimum value in second row is -1 and -3 and -4. So -2, -1, -3 and -4 are the row minimum values. And the column maximum values. So here the maximum value is 5 and here the maximum value is 2. So now you have to find the maximin value and minimax value. The maximin value is -1. Clear? This is maximin value. And the minimax value in column is 2. This minimax value. So now you can cross verify whether it has a saddle point or not. Maximin value equals minimax value. So what is the maximin value here? -1 and the minimax value is 2. Is this equal? No, it is not a equal value. Maximin value is not equal to minimax value. So it has no saddle point. If it has no saddle point, means we have to use the graphical method. By using the graphical method, we can find the optimal strategy for game A, player A, and the optimal strategy for player B. So now I will draw a graph. Draw a 2 vertical lines. Here, you just write the axis A1 and this is A2. So before that, I'll write the probability for A1, A2, A3, A4. So probability, I'll take P1, P2, P3 and P4. So P1 plus P2 plus P3 plus P4 is equal to 1. And for B1, B2, the probability is Q1 and Q2. We have 2 columns and 4 rows. So now you can draw a graph. So here you just observe this. The maximum point value is 5 and the minimum value is -4. So to start from -4. -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. here minus 4, here again minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1 and 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. In previous method, that is 2 cross n games, have considered this is P0 and that is P1, right? So now I will take it as Q0 is equal to 0 and Q1 is equal to 1. And so now you can join the points. First point is minus 2 and 0. So minus 2 means this point and 0 is this point. So now you can join these two points, minus 2 and 0. And the next point is 3 and minus 1. So 3 and minus 1, this point. Now you can join these two points, 3 and minus 1. Next point is minus 3 and 2. So minus 3 and 2 means this point. Join these two points now, minus 3 and 2. So last point is 5 and minus 4. So 5 and minus 4, this point. Join these two points now. Have joined these two points. So now just mention the lines. So here minus 2 and 0. Minus 2 and 0, this line is called as A1. Clear? And 3 and minus 1. 3 and minus 1, this is A2. And minus 3 and 2. Minus 3 and 2 is this A3. And 5 and minus 4, it is A4. Please mention the points and join the lines properly. So now, next step is, in previous problem, in previous method called 2 cross n games, have selected the lower bound and maximum point, right? It is just an opposite of 2 cross n games. Here, I will select the upper envelope. Upper boundary is, this area is upper envelope. So upper boundary and the least point, the most point is for 2 cross n games. So here upper boundary and the least point. So this point is the least point, means that is a down point. So I will select this point is the least point. Clear? So here the lowest point we have to select, the highest boundary, that means higher envelope and the lowest point. The lowest point is, this point is called as lower point, that is we can represent it by n. Clear? So this is the lowest point and upper boundary. So this point is the lowest point. Clear? Now this lowest point is intersected by these two lines, that is A3 line and A4 line. So this least point is intersected by this line, that is A4 line, and this line, that is A3 line. So have selected A3 and A4. So this is the selected points, that is selected line is A3 and A4, and the remaining lines are rejected, that is A2, A1 are rejected. Have selected A3 and A4. So now easily you can find the optimal strategies. So this is a method for M cross 2 matrix, that is M cross 2 games. So here you have to select the highest part, that means the upper part and least point. The lowest point is this point and it is intersected by these two lines, that is A3 and A4. So here in 2 cross n, we have selected the most point, that means highest point, that is n. And in M cross 2 games, we have selected the lowest point called n. That is the difference between the 2 cross n games and M cross 2 games. So it is just an opposite of this M cross 2. So it is just an opposite of this 2 cross n. It is very simple concept. Please understand the concept. So first write the vertical lines and join the points. So here I have considered the columns and row points, that is minus 2, 0, 3, minus 1, minus 3, 2, 5 and minus 4. And join these lines, so you will get the intersected point. And here for m cross 2 games, you have to select the upper boundary and the least point. So this is the least point called as n. In 2 cross n games, we have selected the most point. Clear? So now you can find the optimal strategy for player A and player B. So here A3 and A4 are selected. So in next step, I will consider this P3, P4 and it is B1, that is Q1, Q2. So points are minus 3, 2, 5 and minus 4, that is A, B, C, D. You can write this matrix form for substituting the values. So next step is P1. Find out P1 value. So what is the formula? D minus C by A plus D minus B plus C. D minus C by A plus D minus B plus C. So what is the value of D? D value is minus 4 minus C value is 5. A plus C is, A plus D means minus 3 plus minus 4. Minus B plus C is 2 plus 5. Minus 4 minus 5 is minus 9 by minus 3 minus 4, it is minus 7. 2 plus 5 is 7. Minus 9 by minus 14. Minus minus get cancelled, it is 9 by 14. So P1 is 9 by 14. Here we don't have P1 value, it's cancelled. We have to use P3. So P3 is equal to 9 by 14. P3 is 9 by 14. What is P4? 1 minus P3, it is 1 minus 9 by 14. It is 5 by 14. So P3 is 9 by 14. P4 is 5 by 14. So the optimal strategy for player A is 9 by 14, comma 5 by 14. So now find out for B1, B2. Q1 is equal to formula for finding Q1, D minus B by A plus D minus B plus C. Substitute the values D minus B. D value is minus 4 minus B value is 2 by A value is minus 3 and D value is minus 4. Minus B value is 2 plus C value is 5. Minus 6 by minus 7, minus 7. Minus 6 by 14. It is 3 by 7. Q1 is 3 by 7. And what is Q2? 1 minus Q1. It is 1 minus 3 by 7. It is 4 by 7. The optimal strategy for player B is, 3 by 7 and 4 by 7. Clear? So now finally you have to find the value of the game. So what is the value of the game? Write the formula. So AD minus BC by A plus D minus B plus C. Substitute the values. A into D, that is minus 3 minus 4 into BC is 5 into 2 divided by A plus D is minus 3 minus 4 plus into minus minus, and B plus C is 5 plus 2. So you will get 3 into 4, 12, 10 by minus 7 and 7. So it is 12 minus 10 is 2 by minus 14. So the final answer is minus 1 by 7. V is equal to minus 1 by 7. So minus 1 by 7 means we got the negative value. If you get the negative value means it is gain to player B and loss to player A. So this method is called as M cross 2 games. This method is M cross 2 games because we have n number of rows and we have only two columns in M cross 2 games. So this is a method for finding M cross 2 games. In M cross 2 games, you have to find the upper envelope and the least point. Upper envelope and the least point in M cross 2 matrix. So it is solved by graphically. So last problem is solve the following game M cross 2 problem graphically. Here we have two columns and three rows. Clear? So it is M cross 2 games. So first step is row minima and next one call max. So minimum value is minus 2 and the next minimum value is in second row it is minus 1. The minimum value is 2. In column the maximum value is 3 and here 4. Now maximin value and minimax value. The maximin value is 2. It is maximin value and the minimax value is 3. Is this equal? No, it is not A equal. So 2 is not equal to 3. It has no saddle point. No saddle point here. So now you can solve this by graphically. So now I will use the graphical method. Draw two vertical lines. And this is Q0 and this is Q1 is equal to 1, Q0 is equal to 0. So this is B1 axis and this is B2 axis. So now the maximum value here it is 4 and the minimum value is minus 2. So I will start from minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5. Maximum value is 4. Again here it is minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So join these two points 3 and minus 2 and next one minus 1 and 4. So this point line is A1. And the next point is minus 1 and 4. So minus 1 and 4. This is minus 1 and 4. And next is 2 comma 2. So 2 and 2. It is 2. So here I will join this 2 and 2. So now you can cross verify that. So this 2 comma 2 is A3. This is A2. And this is A1. So now, what is the next step? So in M cross 2 games, we have to find the upper boundary. So here, the upper part is this area and the least value, the lowest value, we got two points are both are in the same level, right? So these two points are in the same level. This is lowest and this is also lowest point because here we got two lowest values. So this point is also lowest value and this point is also lowest value. So here both the points are in the same level. We can consider both the points. So this point comes under which line? A1 line and A3 line. So A1 line and A3 line. So one first possibilities is A1 comma A3. So you can select this possibilities and the next point is comes under A2 and A3. Here we got two points are in the same level. So you can find out for two alternatives. So solution 1 and solution 2. So A1, A3 are selected in the first solution. A2, A3 are selected in the second solution. In first method, you can find out A1 and A3. And in the second solution, you can find out for A2 and A3. Clear? So in first solution, this is solution 1 and this is solution 2. A1 and A3. I'll write the matrix A1 and A3. B1, B2. So A1 is 3 minus 2, A3 is 2, 2. And the second solution, second alternative solution is A2 and A3. B1, B2 is common. A2, A3 means minus 1, 4, 2 and 2. So now you can find out to this solution A, B, C, D and also to this solution. So you can find out for both the solutions because we got the same position. We got two alternative solutions here. So you can find out for this or else to this solution also you can find out. So next step is P1. You can use this solution or you can use this solution. Find out P1, P2 and Q1, Q2. So after that you can find the value of the gain. Value of the gain you have to find out in the last step. Please practice this problem. It is assignment question. So you got two solutions in this problem. So you can find out for the first solution or second solution. So definitely you will get the value of the solution. So finally you have to write the value of the gain. If it is positive means it is gain to player A and it is negative means gain to player B. Clear? So this is called as graphical method by m×2 games. m×2 matrix. So already I have discussed 2×n games and today I have explained m×2 games. In my next session, I will come with a new concept in game theory. Thank you.